Okay. So what do you need to know before designing a facade lighting application? The main considerations, we have six main considerations. These are the context, the color, the contrast, the control, the quality, and the people. I have already explained some of this a while ago. You need to know what is the context of your building. Is it for an office, an old building, for a historical building, for a museum, or whatever is this building you're going to highlight? Is the building needs color? Does it needs RGB? Is it a mall? So if it's a mall, it's okay to have RGB, or an office, or any commercial area. But if it's a institutional building, or for example, government building, then color, I think, is not a good idea. And then you need to know the contrast, because you don't need to floodlight the whole building. You have to make sure that at least there is still dark and light, should have at least a contrast. And then of course, control. Does this building need a lighting control, or are you going to use RGB, which you need to make your building facade like color changing, or is it one color only? And then if it's only one color, then on and off is fine. But if you're planning to create a scene or color changing, then you need to have a lighting control. And then quality. Quality means like how this building look like, and are you trying to just show it off, or you just want to actually most of the time, if you're doing the facade lighting, you want to show off your building, right? Because you want to make your building lively at night. But yeah, I think that quality is for that idea. And of course, for the people, of course, because you want the people to have fun, to appreciate the area, and to have a amazing experience on that place. So you want to impress the people with your facade lighting. And then another luminary another consideration for designing a facade lighting is the luminaires. So for a luminaire, you need to know what is the position of the luminaire. Is it on the ground, or is it on the pole, or is it on the building itself? Is it from up, or from down, or from where? So you need to know the position, because for example, your building is close to the pathwalk. You cannot place your surface mounted floodlight on the pathwalk, because you are stopping the people to have a smooth transition on the pathwalk. So it should be properly positioned. And of course, if your luminaire is bulky and ugly, you don't want to see this luminaire on the daytime. That will destroy your architectural facade or architectural design. And then, of course, the shape. Most of the architects right now wants to have light without luminaire. It's like they want to see lights on the building, but they don't want to see the fitting itself. So make sure that the shape or the size of your luminaire is good enough, or you can hide it, or small enough to hide it somewhere, or to make it invisible to the eye of the passers-by or to the people who can see your building. And then of course, optic. We have different kinds of optic for example, for floodlights, there's wide beam, narrow beam, and different optics gives different effect on your facade. So you should consider, for example, you want to have a even illumination or wall washing in your facade. So you don't need to use a narrow optic. You want to have a wide beam or a linear flood, so you can achieve your wall washing or even illumination in the facade. And then, of course, the output. What will be the output of your luminaire? Is it for just a plain color or an RGB color? And, of course, lighting control. Again, lighting control, because facade lighting now is more of into dynamic. And because of the new technologies of LED, most of the facade lighting right now or today is into LED, and it's much, we can maximize the potential of LED if we also integrate lighting control. So for working consideration, again, this is because you're a lighting designer, you need to know, are you going to do the commissioning as well? Or you're just going to do the design or just the concept? So also you need to ask for the detailed drawings from the client, because it's not only the elevations that you will need, but also the plan view and the detailed drawings. Like for example, if they have 3D files or SketchUp files, you can ask them, and then so you will lessen your time into building it up in your Dalux Evo. So if for example you receive an email saying that they need a facade lighting, then ask all the information to the client and also the drawings and 3D files if they have. And does this lighting project needs only the concept or the whole detailed lighting design? Like they want to see the layout also, and they want to see the specifications of the luminaires, because as a lighting designer you can also do lighting concept only, not the full detailed design. You can do that lighting concept into Photoshop or PowerPoint presentation only, or any like paint or JPEG file. And of course, presentation. Do you need to provide a presentation aside from the lighting calculations? So you need to ask the client. But most of the time, if it's facade lighting, they want to see a presentation. Later on, I will show you one of my lighting design presentation, and I hope you will like it. And of course, deadline. Because facade lighting is really time consuming. You really need to spend time to build your facade, because building up the facade and then putting luminaires, aiming the floodlights, it really takes time. And if your facade is huge, then again, it will take more time. So you need to mention to your client that it will take time. So you will mention to them that you will need at least 1 week or 2 weeks to do the facade lighting design. But if they are on hurry, and they said that's really urgent and I want to do the facade, I want the facade lighting ASAP, then you can do that by sketching it or just giving them the concept and suggest the fitting without any lighting calculation. If you have any other considerations aside from this, please suggest. These are just based on my experience. So floodlight aiming. There are, based on what I mentioned to you about the type of the luminaires to be used in facade lighting, let's focus now for a floodlights. This one, the first one, the floodlights. Sorry, it's not the first one, the fourth one, floodlights. Because most of facade lighting right now, the most used fitting is floodlight or linear flood. So there are different floodlight aiming position and mounting. So you can just offset it from the wall or from the surface here, or from the ground. You can put your floodlight on the ground inside the box if you like, or if not on the floor. But this one you cannot do it in the catwalk. This is the one I mentioned earlier. And you can also put it in the pole, of course, and of course in the wall itself. You can place the floodlight on the wall itself, or if it's a statue, then you can just place it in the base of the statue. And similar, you can put it in the column. And another option here is like how you do it. How if this is a floodlight mounting position, and then this one, the next picture is about how you place your luminaire or the mounting position. So you can place it here on the ground, far away or offsetted from your building or from your facade, or close to your facade. This one is not good, because if this is a window and this is a glass window, this is a wrong concept. Okay. And you can also do facade lighting from afar, like your projector or your floodlight is coming or mounted from the opposite building. You can also do that. And of course, you can put your linear flood or floodlight in the building itself, either in surface mounted or in the wall mounted. And this is one is asymmetrical, so it can both light the catwalk and the facade. And of course, uplighters. See, this one is the usual solutions for a column is doing an uplighting technique like this. So facade lighting, you need to imagine and it's more of artistic and more of creating an effect on the wall. It's not about lux level. But of course, you need to consider what luminaire to be used properly to achieve those kind of effect in your facade.